Hey friends, welcome back to this session on problem solving. And today we are going to solve a problem related to number system. And the question says, represent minus 2 by 3 and 14 by 5 on a number line. Okay, so we have discussed this in detail in the concept lectures. Now time to problem solve the problems. So how to do it? So this is how you have to do it. Okay, so first of all, draw a straight line. In your answer script, you should be using a scale and a ruler and a pencil to draw a number line, and then take a point as zero. Now, depending upon what numbers are to be represented, you have to divide or graduate the number line into some intervals or graduation. So let us say, if you see the numbers are minus 2 by 3 and 14 by 5, it's not a big number, so hence I can afford to take big units here. So this is 1, 2, 3. Okay, and here is the same thing, 1 and 2. So now let me name it 1, 2, and 3. Here it is -1 and -2. This is how you should first of all draw a number line. Now if you see -2 by 3, clearly -2 by 3, where would it lie? It would lie between 0 and 1, isn't it? Because -2 by 3 is definitely less than 0 because it's a negative number, but since it's a fraction, it's not beyond 1, so -1, that is. So hence it will be between 0 and 1, isn't it? Now so that means how to find 2 by 3 between 0 and -1, -2 by 3, sorry. So again, the number is -2 by 3. So -2 by 3, what is the denominator, guys? Denominator is 3, so you have to divide that interval in 3 parts. First of all, what is the step one is find out or identify what do you need to identify? The segment where the desired number lies. Okay, so where does this desired number lies? Which segment? So segment is between 0 and -1. How do I know it? Because 2 by 3 is definitely less than 0, but it is not more than less than 0, but it is definitely more than -1. So now next step is find the denominator, right? Denominator, so in this case denominator is 3, so divide the segment into number of parts found in step 2, isn't it? So in step 2 I found 3, so I'll divide in 3 equal parts, right? So 1, 2, so 3 equal parts I divided, see, for number of equal parts found in 2, right? Now, so hence -2 by 3 will be nothing but this is 1 and this is 2. So this part is -2 by 3. This is how I represent -2 by 3. Similarly, the next is 14 upon 5. Now, what is 14 upon 5, guys? 14 upon 5 can be written as 2 whole 4 upon 5, isn't it? So 2 whole 4 upon 5. Now, that means this number, the segment to be identified is nothing but 2 and 3, because it is definitely more than 2 but less than 3, so it is lying between 2 and 3. Where in 2 and 3? So in the denominator here is 5, so I divide the denominator into 5 equal parts, so I have to put 4 points, 1 2 3 4. So this is not properly divided, so I'll again, so 4 parts, I have 5 parts I have to divide, so 4 points I have to take, 1 2 3 and 4. Now if you see, there 2 and 3, the segment between 2 and 3 has been divided into 5 equal parts. Now 4 parts out of that, so starting from 2, so 1 2 3, and this one is the final point, right? So you should encircle that, and that becomes 14 upon 5. So hence this point here is 14 upon 5, this point here is -2 upon 3. This is how you will represent any fraction or a rational number on a number line.